Maybe I could put, like, Act of Treason in this deck to enable this guy more. Ooh. Let's play the creature first. I kind of feel like using that. A more expensive Blightning. Blightning is the same thing as the Carnage one, but it costs one less. Together, these can deal with the Phoenix, but it's going to take two cards, unfortunately.
Come on, Mo'u. Time to have your day. I will help you through this.
Methods. Strike.
Maybe I should have gotten rid of Yanggu. Dang.
You still have a home. You should go there now.
I'll show you unhinged.
Witnessed enough destruction already.
Let's kick this madness into high gear! Maybe I'll hang on to this, if that's all right with you.
He has first strike and another ability. That's pretty good for a common. The Brawl Bash Ogre lets you sacrifice a creature for free, but this guy is, does it at instant speed.
So cute.
Let's see if this new Tybalt is good. Oh jeez. That's what I want. I was thinking, oh, is there any red black ones here to use?
Please run. A chase, don't.
The only prize I desire is your head.
Fire's out, but the embers burn on.
I adore an audience.
I finally got to do that with this deck and someone else's creature. Have this token right in front of me, and I have like a pile of tokens from when I was drafting. Ah, man, he has another one.
Water, if you want it, fight for it.
Thank you. like a good opening hand. That other part of his ability, when you do Fireblade, Artist deals 2 damage to target opponent or Planeswalker, that's going to be really relevant in Standard right now. All these little tacked-on things that say to target Planeswalker are going to be like extra useful now. In this, well, I won't say meta, but I mean like just, you know, the Planeswalker set thing.
My friend is here to help your pain.
I've been noticing a lot of guys in Magic have like haircuts where the side is shaved. Oh, he can sack himself? So
the more,
he has the
messier.
That decent ability. And he's basically worth 2 of these. So 2 mana, and then he's 1 HP left over basically. Even better if you have Proliferator, puts counters on something, but I'm trying to think of what I can do that with in black and red. I'm starting to think that wasn't really worth it, but I'm starting to get desperate to damage him more. wonder if I can make this more, like, pure goblin stuff. Oh, that's gonna be really good with that. Oh, jeez. That's not good. Oh, cool. I see where this deck is going.
Seems I have been outplayed.
I think I should have just straight up murdered the neonate. Oh, no, then he would have got a 2-2, oh well. Oh no. I'm gonna deal with this eventually, I think. This one. Yeah, murder is a bit excessive on this one. Maybe we'll see if he gets something better eventually. Wait a minute. not enough black man is there. Flying zombies. I don't know why it's not letting me use this. Oh well. I thought I brought it back to my hand last turn. Ooh, another one? Jeez. Yeah, zombies really needed a decent flyer. You know what to do, there's not a lot of other things to do besides press attack. What? I thought I did this, but again, but it's weird. I think that's game. Oh well. It's a sorcery. If I ping that one. I even heard the pow sound of like the thing, and I used my mana instead of that. Maybe it's a little different from what I think in the replay, but.
I do not stand alone.
That's weird to me, seeing the negative two instead of an ultimate there. Well, how big is he that he can just like hold a zombie in his hand like that? I'll put that in my green-white deck when I get around to playing it. Oh, maybe I could turn this deck into an amass deck when I get more decent amass cards. I could craft one of those Minotaur Planeswalkers. There's a menace and a negative two for an amass. Okay. I'm not sure how I feel about using goblins in a non-pure goblin deck. I'm gonna hold on to the dead weight for the archer or slime foot or whatever. You what? We'll hold on to this for when I have at least 4 mana to combo them. Well, he's just gonna take it. Now it's tempting to use this, but I'll wait for the inevitable casting of a Slimefoot or... Whatchamacallit? Poison Tip Archer? Starting to think Demon of Catastrophes would have been better. Just to like really force his hand. Yeah, because that basically puts him in check, right? You shouldn't have attacked. Why would you attack? Oh, could I? Oh no, I just get my mana now. Okay, mana. I think we're gonna go for like mass damage here. Oh, would it be hilarious if we make him lose to his own thing? Because he has to block and loses all these tokens. Taking out the wrong one, but okay. You want to be taking out the Tin 3 Dodger, not one of the bland vanilla goblins. Thank you. You what? Oh, man. Yeah, you can't stop the Tin Street Dodger. It's too good. Should have brought a guy with Defender. I guess I could have attacked with this one. Well.
My presence alone guides you. Truth lies beyond vision.
I like that one, but I don't know how good it is. You gotta be like running really heavy creatures.
Ether itself serves me.
He's playing a lot of the guys that I like to play, these little ETB guys. Doesn't that fall off, though? This bar is not... No. There's no word there. Three, four, do I bring back? Not a lot of good stuff to bring back with this one. Just the little ones. So I'll just play this guy. Should I draw the cards instead? That was a lucky pull. Heart of the cards! Thank you. That's a good choice. That'll probably kill me if I don't get something good. So he's doing mono green, I guess, for the tender shoot dryad. Okay, let's see. So I block. I feed a bunch of monsters to him. And then I still have this one, just in case. I think I'm still dead, but we'll see. Yeah, I think if he just attacks with everything, I die. Ooh, what's this? Oh, he has another one? Dang. Okay, now I see why he chose green. He's got some good choices here. I was thinking blue would be way better for historic, but he's got like a removal spell. He's got the thing that lets you search for more, and the dryad bonkers when you have the card advantage from the Ugin. Oh yeah, maybe I should use my Ugin with the tender shoot dryad. That seems really busted. Yeah, my historic deck is just mono blue, but maybe green would be better. It didn't have like a bunch of permanents. Blue green historic deck. Hmm. Use artifacts. I'm not sure if there's any goblins in black in standard right now, but I have some. That's what I love about mana rocks, is you can use them the turn you play them. Okay, get those out of there. Oh, this guy again, he's so strong. 3-2 haste for 3, and he has these other abilities. Should have held on to the mana at least until after he attacks as a threat. Now I can go like this. I can can turn him into a 3-4. Fuck, he has another one. Well, it's not good. I didn't realize he has the loot as soon as you play him. Man, even if I 2, 3, 4, well, it still got me. 4. Oh, maybe I should have done that, and then I could have potentially drawn something to save me. Should have done that on my turn. Nope, I'm still dead. Looks like he has a lot of curly hair. Yeah, that card's pretty ridiculous. oh wow, the spectacle costs us so much more. I didn't realize. Well. Ooh, he must have got something good if he chose. Okay, there you go.
Thank you.
really use another mana right now. Yes! Yes, yes, yes! Yeah, you put that on there. Two for one. Ah, two of his cards at least. I was kind of like, oh, I don't really want to use it on just the 2/2, but that sealed the deal. Oh, I could have used Sure Strike. Negate. Yeah, I should have used Sure Strike. I didn't even realize the situation was that close to me winning. Maybe this is finally the right deck for Sure Strike. Because I have so many little Neener Neener guys that they want to block. Two mulligans? Poor guy. Okay.
Your champion of justice.
Indestructible. Okay. It comes in as a creature too. I didn't know that.
Share in my light.
Hopefully I draw an ability that lets me grab in. I actually don't feel like using the lock at this time because I can play this one next turn anyways.
Prepare for battle.
So it's a 4/4 indestructible creature that has all damage prevented on your turn for 3 mana. And it goes up as a planeswalker every turn with all those abilities. And oh, I can already use the negative 6 on this turn. On his fourth turn, I think. Oh, I can't do any damage to him, so. He's just pretty bonkers. It does 2 and 2 for each attack on a Ur or Planeswalker. That's. I have a 4-drop enchantment that, I feel like that I should play the creature. Hit. Just fucking block. Well, I don't know why I'm complaining. I pulled this Planeswalker. I didn't feel like using him in multicolor though, but it looks like I should put him in my black-white deck. What are those abilities? Vigilance, lifelink, indestructible?
I believe in you, friend.
It's indestructible, so can't use murder. Go down to. Okay, I don't really have a choice. I have to try it now or never. No! Oh, I'm so dead. Sure. Oh, I can't deal with that, my murder or my negative 3, so I think that's pretty much game. I had the old
you my strength.
Gideon, and you have to use his ability, I think, to make him into a guy that can attack. And that second ability, you gotta pay 6 to destroy a non-basic land? Oh man. Not even just 4 or 5. Like, 5 I think would be more reasonable. It's really more for the first one, the negative 3. Yeah. the effects are really great in this game. There's a discard spell drill bit that might be good in this one. It only costs one if you spectacle. Useful to have that. It's still annoying that you gotta use two cards to deal with that. What? I feel like making a black bread mass deck, but I don't feel like taking apart this one yet. I think we should go full on distance ability second turn. I'll let the imp live for a turn so I can play this one. I'm loving the dual cards. Apparently people were like really not wanting it. Like when Mark Rosewater wanted to introduce dual cards, people kept saying like they were against it. I could have used the Bedeck. Oh, I should have just used Bedeck on him. It doesn't look like we're gonna find a non-basic land to blast. Oh, sweet! We can. Tough decision. I'll go for keeping the ogre. I guess good thing I kept the deck after all. When I made some changes to this earlier, I think I put in more low casting cost ones, which is useful for Rakdos, because you don't want the games going on long at all in black-red. You want to win quickly. Oh, yep, there they get to play something like that. I guess I can use them as sacrifice fodder. Jester guy. I like the first ability. At first I didn't really like the second ability, but we're in a set that has the main theme is planeswalkers basically in it right now, so that second ability is, I'm like, okay, liking it a bit more. I'm more comfortable holding on to this card in my hand against mono black deck because one of my high casting cost ones is in the graveyard. Okay, that's probably a game. Yep. That card sucks, but you know, it's a removal spell. You don't have anything else. I used it for a while, but I eventually took it out of my mono black one. I like the repeating barrage card. It's a lot like this little card I have called Hammer of Boggarden. That's like same concept sorcery but with damage. and you can return it with the cost of the same much as like red mana, but only on your upkeep. Let that get to critical mass, or he starts gaining the life. Oh, I should have played this one, and then just eaten the damage, and then we could repeatedly use those together. Fine. Thank you. Oh, he has a third one? Ugh, outside of shock range, unfortunately. I think he still got me if I block. Yeah, I'm dead.
True power.
the plays. Oh, you didn't? Oh, what?
The land shall conquer you.
And do this again. You want to attack? You want to take out some more lands? It's a negative 8. Indestructible. Ugh. Wait, what? How did it live? There's no, like, track to, like, look back on the thing. I blocked with the Instigator and the Pyromancer, but it's still alive. Oh, what? WTF? Maybe I accidentally blocked with two goblins. Yeah, I'm starting to think I accidentally...
I am fragile.
Well, that's in standard. I have the old version of that. I like it. Let's see what we got I'm gonna discard that one. Okay. Yeah, the negative 3 on that Bedeck is really useful, especially for removal. The plus 3, negative 3. Expecting like a sure strike or something ridiculous.